Hey guys, it's Nate, aka The Foot Accountant. Welcome back to the channel. We are starting kind of the end of FIFA 20 videos today with some end game team reviews. In this video, I'm going to be taking a look at some of the teams you guys have sent me via Twitter just to look at some of the clubs, the club flexes, the team flexes, the squad flexes, the cool players that you have packed, and the squads you have built and put together inside of FIFA 20 Ultimate Team. In this year, since we are towards the end of the game, honestly, the very closing stages, I want to take a look at some of the stuff that you guys have been able to accumulate in your clubs this year and just kind of talk about it. There's a lot of interesting things that I think we can see from these, and of course, just honestly admire all the grind, all the hard work, and all the effort you guys have put in with trading, with SBCs, with just grinding the menus, grinding the game for objective cards. We're going to look at a lot of that stuff inside of this video, but this is honestly just a chance to kind of look back on FIFA 20 as well and just kind of to remember all the cool cards that have come out. There's a lot of different types of squads that we have that I'm going to be showing off today and probably in another video on this channel as well. So this is what we're basing everything off of today. I'm going to have a video on this channel of my complete club review. This is my A1 team, I guess you could call it. I'm going to have a full club review and a full squad flex video on its own for my club. That's going to be coming later. But for now, we're talking about you guys. So I put out this tweet on Twitter a couple days ago. I said, hey, we're in the home stretch. Show me those end game squads that you've been working on this year. And then I went to show mine just as an example. All right. So we're going to take a look at today's squads. There's a lot of interesting things that we can take from these squads. And I'm going to talk through a lot of this stuff. I'm also going to read some of the comments that each person kind of tweeted at me as well, just to kind of give some backdrop on the scenario. So this one is from Don. He's got Aubameyang, Aguero, KDB's award winner SBC. I think that's a card we're going to see a lot today. Nainggolan, Eden Hazard player moments. Now that's an interesting one. The objective Mendy, of course, Militao, David Luiz, Danilo, and team of the year Alisson with team of the year Conte in the middle there. And on his bench, I don't know if any of those are loans, of course, but I'm guessing that Neymar is probably first owner because usually you don't like to flex loans on your bench. I don't know. Some people do, but this is an interesting squad, right? Right away, I'd like to point off, I feel like Aubameyang and Nainggolan, maybe just Aubameyang, is a player that probably is really good in this game because he's very pacey, probably has decent dribbling, and of course the TOTS item is very fast. But I don't feel like he gets enough love as probably a really good player in this game. I think it's just because he doesn't fit like the quickest turning meta, you know, the absolute highest agility and highest balance, like some of the other guys, like maybe a Ben Yedder, Mbappe, Aguero might fit in. This award winner Hazard card is very interesting. This guy must be a Real Madrid fan or a Belgian fan, which I do know he's from Belgium. So that explains some of the Belgium guys that are in here. But this player moments Hazard was a card that a lot of people didn't like right away at the beginning of when it came out because it was very expensive. But that was like one of the high, that was a team of the season level card. And I think we got that SBC in like the team of the year time frame or somewhere around there. It was at least early 2020. So that is a really cool card. I bet he's got a lot of games. David Luiz, Shapeshifter. I'm going to talk a lot about, Summer Heat. I'm going to talk a lot about Summer Heat cards because you can tell in a lot of these squads that we'll look at today that the Summer Heat promo and the last few weeks, maybe the last month or so on this game have really affected a lot of people's squads. So that is a really nice squad from Don right there. Nice mix of attacking play, but also some nice midfielders as well. This is squad number two is from Dan. On Twitter, he says, mostly first owner. Tonight, you've been experimenting with Thiago at left CDM and Davies left back alternative. Right now, he's got Bernat and Mateus in there. He's got a Eusebio moments, Ronaldinho moments, team of the year, Conte, Mbappe, and Cristiano Ronaldo alongside of Ramos and Varane as center backs. Moments, Mateus, and moments, Van der Sar, of course, that UCL Bernat. And then he's got Pogba. Wow, dude, this is a stacked freaking club right here. This is incredible. This is a freaking GG. He said it's mostly first owner. I obviously can't tell from this picture who is first owner, but this is the first point I want to make about squads that a lot of the squads you guys are sending me, right? It looks like so many squads have been impacted, is the word probably, impacted by at least the past couple weeks in this game. Now, notice what we have here. We have a lot of icon moments and a lot of team of the years. Now, of course, I don't know how many he's packed from these, But one thing that I'll talk about right away is when we look through a lot of these squads, it is very easy to tell that the team of the year pack weight was a lot higher this year. Now, I know team of the years came back into packs. They're in packs right now during preseason. But I feel like even during the actual team of the year promo, I had never packed a team of the year before. I ended up packing Conte twice and Allison once, right? And that was way more than I had ever packed in the past. I feel like a lot of people this year packed more team of the years than in past years. And then, of course, the Icon Moments SBC and the Prime or Moments upgrades that have been out in the past couple, about a month or so, has really impacted a lot of clubs as well. That is a mental, insane squad, especially with some of these just the team of the year card, man. I love that card design. Huge, huge fan of those. I like how we have the most recent Champions League Showdown SBC involved there as well. Dan, incredible squad, man. That is about as good as it gets, bro. All right. This is Archibald, one of the moderators in my live stream. He's got a really cool picture here because he's got all the flexes. This is an entire club flex in one picture with all the untradeable cards that he has got in his club with his starting 11 involved in there as well. We've got a Messi, Ronaldo, Team of the Year De Bruyne. We've got a Sergio Ramos. And then again, a lot of summer heat cards with Dembele, with Ribery. Two guys we're going to see a lot. Mendy, we've seen him a lot already. Danilo, arguably one of the best right backs in the game. And then some really saucy red picks. I actually remember packing for Archibald, this account right here, packing 93 Mbappe. This Mbappe 93 inform red from one of those extra player picks. I think it was during, was that during Foot Birthday where they did the extra player picks from objectives? I think that's where I got this card. But again, Varane, Mane, like this is an absolutely stacked club. Kaká, Foot Birthday, Hazard, and tradable is dope. Team of the season, Josef Martinez is awesome. Atal, a team of the year, Allison, team of the year, Rabo. So he's got 1, 2, 3 team of the years in this club. The upgraded Alaba, Valverde, Ansu Fati, João Felix, Greenwood. Tons and tons of crazy cards inside this club. Archibald, GG, man. That's a sick looking team. Next one, we're moving on. This is from David on Twitter. He says, that's all before they got quick sold. So he must have had it with FIFA 20 and he ended up quick selling his team. But this is the squad he had before that. Prime Dalglish with the Road to the Final João Felix. Foot Birthday Hazard. We've seen him pop up a couple times now. 99 VVD. That's the first VVD we've seen today. Semedo, that's the first one of him. 89 Militao, 93 Ferland Mendy, Valverde, and Allison. Modric, I think that's the first Modric we've seen in a starting 11. That's a card that I still use from time to time. Really, really good card right there. One of the best flashbacks, if not the best flashback SBC in my opinion, that we saw this year. All right, moving on. Let's keep the train rolling. This is Octavio. He's got the Jurgen Klopp manager card. Nice. We'd love to see it. Kaká moments. Essien. This might be from Icon Swaps, man. That's something I haven't mentioned yet, right? How many of you guys are still rocking cards from Icon Swaps in your teams, right? Probably not a lot of you. But anyways, he's got the award winner KDB. Ribery, again, another Mendy. Kimpembe. I think that's the first Kimpembe we've seen. That's a nice card. Summer Heat version with Lenglet and Areola in goal. Dude, we got to get you a different goalkeeper, bro. Can we get you like Team of the Season Steve Mandanda? That'd be perfect for you right there. Red Lala's dope. Atal is a very rare card to pack as well. And then this Ousmane Dembele is in a lot of people's teams too. Very overpowered card. I like this squad, man. I like this squad a lot. I'm wondering who you play at CDM and like center mid. What do you play in game? I'm guessing maybe you play Atal up towards the front, and then I'm not entirely sure where you play KDB and Atal, but definitely have a CDM with Essien. Still, dope squad, bro. GG's. This is from Eastside. He says, my RTG squad, all untradeable. There's one card that I see here that is a legendary pack pull on FIFA Ultimate Team. Prime Icon Moments 94, Rude Hullet. This guy's got untradeable Rude Hullet moments and untradeable Prime Pele in his team alongside with two 99 rated team of the seasons and De Bruyne and Lewandowski. And he's got Tots Neymar, bro. This is a red listed account right here, bro. Red, wow, Red Ramos as well. Red Lala. That is a crazy account for pack look. Eastside Rosaneri is the guy tweeting this to me. G freaking G's, man. That's a crazy looking team. All untradeable as well. That is freaking dope. All right, we have a couple more lads. And who else can we put? We can't have a squad review video without a team of the season red version of Cristiano Ronaldo. 99 rated red Ronaldo. Of course, team of the season cards have been in player picks throughout the Summer Heat promo and in the preseason promo now. So a lot of time we've had in the past, honestly, like 3.5-4 months to pick up Tots cards. This is the first Bruno Fernandes I think we've seen. So that's a GG. And the first Moments Vieira, which a lot of people are now using, I think, as a center back. Vinicius is a very popular card that got upgraded as a Summer Heat Showdown. Another Freeland Mendy, Diego Carlos. That might be the first one we've seen of him. And then again, a Semedo, a Ter Stegen, and a Lenglet. I mean, these guys in the back here with the Lenglet, with the Ter Stegen, the Semedo, the Mendy, usually like a Ramos or a Varane or a Militao as well. Just the amount of like... everybody's back line. If you look at a lot of these squads we've looked at, I mean, look at all the La Liga representation we have in the back lines here. La Liga, La Liga, La Liga. I mean, look at all these squads. Look at all these squads, bro. They have some version of a La Liga player in the back line. Literally all of these squads that we've looked at today have Mendy, Militao, or Ramos, or Varane. Somebody in the back line that is from La Liga. I think that's one of the biggest takeaways from this year as well. Is just the fact, especially coming from Ter Stegen being so overpowered, Lenglet being overpowered in the early game. A lot of people used Umtiti in the early part of the game as well. Of course, the Scream PK. So EA really pushed us towards La Liga back lines this year. At least that's how the cards fell with special cards in this game. All right, two more. Let's move on. 99 Lewandowski, team of the season card. Up at striker with a... this Delaney card, a lot of people said this guy is really, really insane, which is dope. I think this was an SBC, and that's one of the other things I wanted to point out too, as we look at a lot of these squads, you know, there's a fair amount of SBC cards that we're seeing. Vinicius was an SBC. This was an objective, SBC, SBC, objective, SBC. Like, a lot of these cards are SBC cards from the Summer Heat promo. I mean, look at all these SBC cards that you're seeing in here, right? Just this year in total for FIFA 20, there were so many more SBC cards available. There were just so many more SBCs that were released in this year. And that's what we're going to talk about a lot in the coming months for getting ready for FIFA 21 as well. Looking back on FIFA 20 and saying, hey, how did those SBCs affect the market? We've got a Maradona. I think that's the baby version. Interesting. GGs though. Moments Best. Not a card you see all the time. Moments Brucha. That's very cool. And then again, La Liga back line. Ramos, Varane, Lala, and then Alphonso Davies, right? That's a very popular card this year as well. A lot of special Bayern Munich cards towards the end of the year, of course, with Champions League and stuff going on as well. That definitely helped out. Again, this is the last squad, and we saved a good one for last. He says, all untradeable with a smiley face. And you know why he's sending that smiley face, right? Imagine in your own club packing prime icon moments. R9, Air 9 moments, man. 15 million coins worth of untradeable value in the club. And you get to pair him up with an untradeable first owner 98 team of the season, Neymar. Unbelievable. And you've got Prime Root Hullet untradeable. These are the types of cards you would see in somebody's team after like FIFA 19 or FIFA 18 doing icon SBCs. We don't have those this year, man. All we have are icon upgrades, and you're still seeing these cards in people's clubs, which is crazy in my opinion. Just goes to show the SBC addiction is alive and well in the user base of FIFA Ultimate Team. Again, two crazy team of the year cards in here with De Jong and with Mbappe. Zambrata, this is like the second Zambrata I think we've seen today. Diego Carlos, Prime Icon Moments, Yashin, Cannavaro Moments, and then Tagliafico. I believe this Tagliafico was an objective. Correct me if I'm wrong, but Tagliafico had a couple of special cards this year. But that is a very nice left back. He must really love that card, and I bet he's got a lot of games played with him because that is that's a card that's been around for a long time. But again, boys, looking back on a lot of these different squads that we saw here, there's a lot of cool cards that we've had out this year, and I just find it, again, so interesting the impact that, Summer Heat cards have had on this, especially in the last couple of weeks and the past couple of months, right? I bet if I asked you guys, hey, what were your squads looking like around the team of the season time frame before Summer Heat, we would have probably seen a lot more cards in there that were maybe like the Essien, maybe like the Areola. You know, during team of the season, you have some of the cards, of course, like a Foot Birthday Hazard in there, or maybe a UCL Live Militao, which you don't have. Again, a lot of these other Summer Heat cards just upped the ante and put in so many high rated cards into this game that just made it, you know, it just took squads to another level. And I think that is also why that Summer Heat promo is going to go down as arguably the best promo in FIFA Ultimate Team history, just because of the amount of cards that it gave us, the value that those cards were, and the stats that were given out on those cards as well. Crazy upgrades. So yeah, boys, that is the first ever, honestly, team review video on this channel. If you enjoyed it, smash the thumbs up button. There's going to be another one of these coming this week. And I think I'm honestly going to start to do these throughout the year in FIFA 20, because these are FIFA 21, because these are honestly very fun to do. And it's going to be fun to see the progression of people's squads throughout the year, right? It's going to be fun as we start from, like, you know, 79, 80 rated, 81 rated gold cards in the next few, in a month or so when FIFA 21 comes out, and then moving up to these types of squads as we get towards the end of the year. If you did enjoy it though, boys, smash a thumbs up on it. Comment down below if you do have any questions. And of course, subscribe to the channel if you are new. Thank you for flexing your clubs on me. It's great to see all you guys have accomplished this year in FIFA 20. We're going to do it all again in FIFA 21. It's been Nate, the Foot Accountant. I will catch you guys later. Peace out.